it, you bring Jesus on the scene instantly. If you pay attention to God's word, you will find that faith comes spontaneously, that is naturally. Where God wants us to be is where our heart is. He plants us where our heart is. An expression and belief that Jesus is reliable to give you a slot of faith.
God's undisputable and incontestable power is being demonstrated as the morning water is ministered by the evangelist sent by Prophet T.B. Joshua in Jesus' name. As satanic forces tremble at the mention of the name of Jesus Christ, the demons confess their evil activities. Watch and see what happened when light met darkness in the life of this woman.
Fire! All over my body. Fire! Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Speak out! Who are you? Who are you? Who are you in this body?
We are marine goddess.
How many of you are inside this body, you demon? How many of you?
2 billion.
Who else?
Python.
So you are a python? Fire! You are a python. What have you done to her, you demon?
The family has slept with a prophecy and they have used her to sacrifice.
Okay.
So we initiated her.
You initiated
and that
her?
Is the same girl. God, must I go?
What have you done to her?
To enjoy her with power and strength. So we don't agree.
Okay.
So we empire with 2 billion serpents.
Okay, how do you destroy them, your family? How do you destroy them?
I kill them like chicken.
You kill them like chicken?
Yes.
How? Explain. How do you operate?
I kill them. I said they have sinned against me. So I kill them.
How many of them have you killed? How many of them?
Uncountable. She doesn't know her mother. Her father too, I kill.
You kill the mother, you kill the father.
I kill all the family. She doesn't know all the family. I kill them. You she kill was them. Running away from my kingdom.
Who are you that is killing them? Who are you?
I am Colette.
What have you done to her career?
She is very brilliant. Very brilliant. But we don't want her to succeed. Because of divine threat.
Why don't you want her to succeed? Why don't you want her to succeed, you demon? Why don't you want her to succeed?
Because she is our sacrificial lamb.
She's your sacrificial lamb?
Yes! He has used her to atone for the sin committed by her great-great-grandparent from Poland Shrine.
They dedicated her to you?
Yes!
What else have you done to her?
Yeah, we force her to sleep with people so that we can get more people in our marine
You cause her to sleep with people.
Oh, yeah.
How? Explain, you demon.
Yeah.
How do you operate? How? How do you use her?
They're very careful with me. You understand?
Bring out. How do you use her? How do you make her to sleep with people?
We enter there and we enter the man too.
You enter there and you enter the man too.
So that we can get a soul in our kingdom.
Okay, what else have you done to her? What else have you done to her? What are the evil things you have done to her?
We kill her, but your master has created another body within her.
We kill her?
Yes, we cut her heart. Your master has sold it. We even born with her. She didn't die. We shoot her. She didn't die. So we have got without her. We are too delicious.
Okay.
So that we can die in the divorce of two things. Divine strength and power for unknown.
How long have you been in this body, you demon?
Since childhood.
You
fly like a vulture. You fly like an eagle.
You fly like an eagle?
Yes, you fly because she's a warrior.
When you fly, what happened? What do you do?
We fight in the dark cloud.
You fight in
the dark. We fight in the dark cloud. We are the princess of the dark cloud. Look, when her rain wants to fall, the rain doesn't know what to fall because the cloud was very dark. We use summit block to block the cloud as you shoot and pray. And the summit block got broken. Now the rain is falling. The time has come. But we have come to fight. But
okay, right now it is time for you to go in the name of Jesus Christ. Out in the name of Jesus Christ. All of my body. All of my body. In the name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus. Your ring, your crown. Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Take your ring, your crown, all over body. Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Fire. Fire. All over body. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the blood of Jesus Christ. Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. No hiding place for you, you demon. Fire. Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. All over body. Fire. Your ring, your crown. Your head, fire in the name of Jesus Christ, wherever that power is located. Fire! Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Fire! Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. No hiding place for you, you demon. Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. All over your body. Your head. Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Fire in the name of Jesus Christ. All over your body. All of you all together. Fire! 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 Fire in the name of Jesus. No hiding place for you yet. Fire in the name of Jesus. Fire! 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 Fire in the name of Jesus. All of our body, wherever that power is located, in the name of Jesus, in the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the blood of Jesus. Fire in the name of Jesus. All of our body, your head, your toe, take your ring, your crown. Fire! You python. You demon. Fire in the name of Jesus. You python, you demon. Fire in the name of Jesus. Your ring, your crown. Take them up in the name of Jesus Christ. Fire in the name of Jesus. Out! 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 Jesus' name. Fire in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, you are declared free. In Jesus' name. Hands up, madam. Give thanks to God.
Emmanuel. People of God, Emmanuel. Indeed, God is with us. My name is Mary Penuku Menyo. I come from Ghana in the Volta region. The problem that brought me to the Synagogue Church of All Nations was that I was held in a bondage, serious bondage. And because of Christ, I was translated from the kingdom of darkness to his marvelous light today. My testimony goes like this. My parents were the origin from Bakpa, Avadue, and they traveled to Ivory Coast. They stayed there for fishing. And that time I was born with them then. Then a message came to them one day that my family need me. They should release me to them to atone for the sin committed by my great-great-great-grandfather. They told my family that there was serious death in my family, that my great-great-grandfather has sinned against the God's calling, which results in a curse in my family. So the God has appointed me that I am the only one that they can send to him to atone for the sin committed by my great-great-grandfather.
So explain to us what it was you were told that your great-great-grandfather actually committed.
They said that my great-great-grandfather has slew with a chokosi. In Nigeria, we call it osu. In English, it's an outcast. So my great-great-grandfather slept with osu girl, which results in a curse in my family. Like a week, people can die like 10, 5 in my family. That they went and asked the oracle, Colin, and he said that he was the one killing the person, people in my family. So he needed made a virgin girl, baby girl, to for sacrifice because of fear and anxiety, trauma in my family. They carry me from my mother to go to atone for the sin. It happened that my mother couldn't carry the burden, so it was my father that brought me to Ghana in my hometown. Then they buy horse, cutlasses, clothes, beads, like in the form of someone who is going to get married. A bride. They took me to Mafi, Dugamen, Collins Shrine for the atonement. Initiation rite has made towards me. They took me to a riverside. Then they initiate me of a journey of no return. A journey of no return. Then a public humiliation was organized. You need that they have to humiliate you to the public. So I was humiliated. My clothes were stripped. They tear it. My hair was shaved. And I was introduced to an old priest as my husband and with the other maidens.
So you mean to say, sister, that as a very young girl, almost, just give us an idea of your age at this period where you were taken and given as a sacrifice to this shrine?
You know, I didn't actually recollect my age, but I was very young. We have seniors. It's like a system. So they told me I was then 1 year before they took me to the shrine. So this was how I was humiliated to the public humiliation. They'll humiliate you. Now the work we do in the system, a chocosy system. We have seniors. I am the junior, very young. They give me a name, Mama V. Yes. That means sumo a chocosy girl, sumo outcast, sumo osu girl. So as my job, I have to knelt down and pray to the oracle that let somebody sing so that we can get more people in our kingdom, in their kingdom. I should beg, because we have seniors, you know, they have to come. Another person must follow you so that you too become a senior. For in my case, I was praying in my language, Evinevalo. Evinevalo, it means let somebody come, let somebody come, because I am tired. But in my case, nobody was coming. Nobody was coming at my age. Nobody was coming. Nobody. And another work they do, we also do. The priest will just point at you. Hey, they can call you chicken, goat, cow. You know, you are a cow. They call you, they sleep with you. You line up, they just sleep with you, just like that.
You're talking as if there are many young ladies like yourself in that shrine. Can you tell us how many people were in this slavery in this shrine?
About 500 in the shrine that they held me, Colin Sharia, about 500. And we have other shrine, but our own was the headquarters.
And all of these girls, you mean to say that a very elderly man, a priest, a chief priest, was actually sleeping with all of these young ladies as a ritual?
Yes. He will point at you, goat, chicken, cow. Line up, and he will sleep with you. On top of it, when he sleep with you and you get pregnant and you give forth that child, you have to take care of it, you yourself. He will not help you, but the child belongs to them. Another work is that we bring horses and cutlasses to the shrine, so we need to farm for the gods. The priest, as a junior and at my age, they gather all the 5,000, gather their homes, their cutlasses, and their farmland is very far. Very far. I have to carry it for my seniors. And we cross through rivers. Sometimes I'll fall inside the river. All that. And nobody was coming. They say I bring another spirit to the shrine.
Okay, you're talking about the work that you were doing in the shrine as someone that had been dedicated to these gods right from the age of 1 year old. You were mentioning about also preparing charms for people. Can you explain more about this?
Yes. In the system too, people come, you know. They come. Since I did not attain my puberty rights, I'm the one, junior, to prepare charms for people. We call it aboko here. Ambrobes will come so that I will prepare them the charm so that they will be able to use it. When they shoot them, they will not die. Even when they cut them, it will not penetrate. And that charm is normally called koku in my language. my assignment is to prepare the charm. The more I prepare the charm, the more spirit that enters me. Then the priest, finally, 2 years later, when they sent me there, finally died. And when he died, they said, I bring a different spirit. This girl is an evil child. I keep it calm. Yes. So when the priest died, I was then very young. Since he is my husband, I have to perform widowhood rites because he is my husband. The widowhood rites also continues. They have to shave my hair. We were confined in a room to stay there for 6 days without water, no food. On the third day, I couldn't continue with the hunger and the stress, so I collapsed. By God on my side, I revived and continued the rituals. Till 6 months, they cleansed us from the widowhood rites. Then, after the widowhood rite, I continued to stay. We continued to stay normal, like to perform our usual duty. For me, I was very, very stubborn. I go around because they ask you that you shouldn't go out. When you go out and they catch you, you will be punished, severely punished. But for me, that doesn't get into my head though, because I need food to eat. I need food at all costs. So I will sneak out to go to churches or something to go and hide. Sometimes even children will be following, hey, mama vi, because they've never seen the, because you are naked, they'll be hooking around. I don't mind. I need food. So one time when I was, I went usual to ask for food from people, tourists were snapping pictures. They came around to check the village. So they found me. It was strange to them. They said I should stop because we were asked not to talk about it. Though. If you talk about it, do you want your family to destroy? Do you want to die? I said no, but in my back I'll say it though because I don't like this kind of lifestyle. So the tourists met me. They snapped me this picture. Then they asked me, why? Why are you like this? And I told them everything. So 6 months later, they came. They negotiate with the shrine owners that this system is very barbaric. It's inhuman that you capture young girls to put them here and use them. It's not good. So we have come into agreement that you should liberate them. They pay some amount, huge sum of amount, 6 million and a cow. So they were able to, white people were able to pay the money and the car. Even they were not agreeing to collect the amount because they asked the cow, are we going to sleep with them? Are we going to sleep with the animals? But they came, they finally agreed and they liberated us finally.
Okay, so just to understand what you're saying, sister, one time when you actually escaped from the shrine looking for food, you met some foreigners who were tourists who actually took a picture of you and you explained the circumstances that you were in. And several months later, these same foreigners actually came with another organization and actually bartered with the head of that shrine and actually agreed to an exchange of money and also some other items to release yourself and the other girls that were in captive in that shrine. Now, how old were you at this point?
I was 8 years old.
So you'd been in that shrine your whole life. As long as you can remember, you were living and brought up in that shrine.
Yes.
Okay. And you mean to say that the picture we're seeing here was the picture that was taken by those foreign tourists who met you in that condition?
Yes.
Okay.
After our liberation, Liberation too has brought another problem. The I don't know where to go. I don't know my village. I don't know where I come from. So it was an elderly woman, inmate. She took interest of me, taking care of me. She told me the story I told you about myself. She told me like this, that she knows where I come from, that I come from a town, an island, Abadue. That is where I come from. Then she showed me, and I traced the direction I went there, my family house. When I went, they said, I will not enter, that if I enter the house, I might bring the curse back to them. So I was banished again from my family. I do not have nowhere to go, so I have to return back to the shrine to stay there alone.
So at the age of 8, you actually found where your family was living, but they banished and rejected you again.
They rejected me because they said, if they welcome me into the family, I might bring the curse back to them. Actually, they used me for sacrifice. If they welcome me, I might bring the curse back to them. So I was driven out of the town. And I went back. I don't have anywhere to go. I went back to stay in the shrine alone. So life continued there. I have to feed for myself. I go pluck mangoes. When people burn their charcoals, I'll go and look, pick some, and sell in order to take care of myself. I stay alone for about 3 years. And one day I was selling. Then one of the NGO, International Needs Organization, saw me. I said, Mama V, but we have liberated you. Why are you still here? And I told her the other side of my story. So during our liberation, the elderly ones, they were giving them training, that they were giving them money to settle with. Some were trained to do batik, tie and dye and all that thing. But for me, tender aid, that money if they give me, even my family does not want me, and you want to give them that kind of money, if they take, they will not take care of me. So the money should be with you people to take care of me, to go to school to the kind of level I want. Because in the shrine, I love school. When I see school children dressed up nicely going to school, I like it. So when they go to the school like that, I will go and hide under the teacher's table so that I can look, because if the children look at me, they will start hooking me around. Mama V, because of the way I dress. So I'll go under the table, the teacher's table. The teacher to like me very well. I'll go under to look at what they are writing. So I also draw a line to write A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3. That time I know how to say standing, sitting, eating, pulling, pushing, and all that.
So you mean to say, sister, that you were brought up not wearing any clothes. You were brought up living naked, moving around naked. That's how you were actually brought up.
Yes. So they took me. They said, since I choose education, they will educate me. So they gave me to several people. They pay my school fees by books and other things. I don't know. But God see me through. I was able to complete senior secondary school with the help of IM. After my education, problem, challenges started between the woman I was staying with, between the I and. So the woman sacked me. So I have to go. And I heard that since they have sacked me from the village, they show me one relative at a flower. So I went there. Since the woman sacked me, I went there to stay with her. From frying pan to fire, the suffering started.
But before you go ahead, sister, just to understand what you're saying, even though physically you had left this shrine and people were trying to help you go through your education, because that evil spirit was still inside of you, it was still pushing you to live a life of slavery to the point that wherever you went, you were experiencing that extreme suffering. Is that right?
Yes. Yes. I experienced rejection because in my life, I stayed with 11 people and series of rejection. They'll sack you, go away, you don't know what to do. I stay with 11 people with all treatment and abuse. So I went back. The spirit still come to me. They come. So when I went to Aflao, I had a dream that cars were destroying, raptures are taking place. Cars were destroying, buildings are destroying, and I cannot fly. People are flying, I can't fly. Then I saw the Savior, the Most High God, Jesus Christ.
Okay, so from what we understand from what our sister's saying, she has really passed through many terrible, horrific life experiences before her final coming to the Synagogue Church of All Nations. And you were explaining, sister, that spirit continued to attack you. Could you just explain just briefly how those attacks would happen and how that would affect you and cause you to behave?
I talk about abuses, sexual abuse. Any man at all, any man want to sleep with me? Eh? Even if telling them my story to, they want to sleep with me. They will enter the man and enter that the man should sleep. For me, I don't know. By the time they finish sleeping with me, then they say, go. I don't need you again. I go. And I met a man who said, you, this international needs, they are not properly taking care of you. I love you. Me too. I love him. That he said he wants to help me and want to marry me. After going down with me, sleeping with me, he said, everybody has needs. So if I think my needs will be provided by him, I should be joking. He drove me out. So when I went to Aflao and I had a dream and I saw Jesus Christ, cars were destroying, buildings are destroying. I saw people flying. They are going to heaven. I cannot fly. Then I asked Jesus, why is that I cannot fly? I see people going, no, I can't go. Is it because of my sin? I have sinned against you. I cannot control myself. Then he told me, I will put something on you that will stop you sinning.
Okay. You know what, sister? We want to now talk about the area whereby you actually found yourself here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations. We know that journey started a long time, even when you had that revelation, even in the midst of this terrible attack. But because of time, we want to understand how you finally came to be in the Synagogue Church of All Nations. So just explain that to us.
I would say during my trials, during when I was wounded, broken, on my way of Damascus, I saw a good Samaritan, a woman. I told her my story. After the dream, snakes were entering my body. I can see them. They were entering my vein, my stomach. There were three pythons. They entered inside me. They were here. Another one passed here. Another one passed here. Very big. Another one passed here. Then the small, small one, they used to tie me. So I told the woman. Then she said, the only person that can deliver you from all these demons is Prophet TV Joshua. And that good Samaritan, a woman, helped me. Help me, it wasn't easy. Tough, very tough. Before, at first, last year.
Sorry, sister, you mean to say that this good Samaritan actually assisted you to come here to the Synagogue Church of All Nations, is that right?
First.
Okay, so now, she met you, you explained your terrible situation. She now advised you that God would use Prophet TB Joshua to deliver you, and she assists you to come in. Now, by the grace of God, we know that last week you were here in the Synagogue Church of All Nations. Finally, God brought you here. 2 weeks ago, you were here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations. Tell us your experience when you came to the church and the morning water was ministered to you.
When we get here, the morning water was ministered. A giant man rose within me, was talking. He was just talking. Let me see. Somebody just blew me, my eye. I said, and I fell, and I got up, and I look, and I thought that it was the evangelist that blew me like that. I wanted to, fight him. That why is that he blew me like that? But looking at the video before I came here, I see that nobody blows me. It was divine blow.
Well, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So during that whole period of the deliverance, all you could recall was as if a giant man was within you, fighting, speaking, and suddenly you experienced something hitting you, and you fell to the ground, and that was the power of God defeating those demonic forces that have held you in captive right since your childhood. Is that right?
Yes.
Well, glory be to God. And ever since that incredible deliverance here in the Synagogue Church of All Nations, just tell us, what are the changes you've witnessed in your life?
At first, I can't sleep. In the night, I have to go around. I cannot sit at one place. With this snake, and you are sitting, when you are sitting there, you are sitting on snake. You are sleeping, you are sitting on snake. You have to go mad. I went mad. But after that blow, the snake melted. I was able to sleep like a baby. At first, I don't know whether I'm human being or I see people like, I don't see myself as a normal mommy. But now, divinity has now mixed with my humanity. I am now a normal human being in Jesus' name.
Well, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So our sister really knows what she's talking about here. She's been under this bondage for her entire life. And just since the deliverance, she's been walking and living in freedom. And sister, how old are you right now?
I don't know my age. And I don't even know my mother. I don't know any. I don't know my age. So I cannot tell you how old am I.
Okay.
I can't.
So
I don't know.
As you're talking now, you have no idea of the whereabouts of your parents or your extended family members. Because right from that childhood, right from a baby, you were separated from them.
No.
So we can really understand what our sister has actually passed through as a result of this evil spirit that entered her right from a childhood after she was used as a sacrifice to atone for the sins of her family. And we give glory to God that that curse was finally broken here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations. And sister, before moving ahead, we'd like to ask you, in the light of this experience, what do you want to advise our viewers all over the world?
First, our advice, all viewers all over the world, that evil kingdom exists. They want you to join them. The only way is that if you sin, you go to them. So they are also praying tirelessly for you to sin so that you join them. So my advice is that stay away from sin. Second advice is that I have seen powers upon powers, but there is power beyond power. That is the God of Prophet TV, Joshua. The God of Prophet TV, Joshua. Divinity that has residence in a human being, Prophet TV, Joshua. To liberate me from the kingdom of darkness to his glory. Hallelujah!
Well, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ one more time. Once again, we give all the glory to our Lord Jesus Christ. He is the one that has liberated our sister. And there's a wonderful, very valuable lesson that we can learn from her experience. Physically, she was liberated from the shrine where she was living as a young girl. She was taken out of that shrine physically. But spiritually, she was still under the torment of that evil spirit. And it was only here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations where she finally received complete and total liberation from her past through the deliverance in the name of Jesus Christ. And sister, we actually have a message for you from Prophet TB Joshua. Upon hearing your story and hearing what you have passed through, Prophet TB Joshua actually used some people, made contact with some people in Ghana to try and locate your family home and where it is you are coming from. You said earlier that you don't know your mother, is that right?
Yes.
And you don't know your other family members?
No.
Okay. Well, by the grace of God, through the arrangements and the intervention of God's servant, Prophet TB Joshua, in the church today, we have a lady. She is going to come forward right now. And she will be in the best position to explain who she is to our sister here. So right now, we actually, before anything else, we want to quickly hear a word from one of the ladies here. She is one of the people that God actually used Prophet TB Joshua to bring about the other family members that are here. Sister, you are welcome. Can you introduce yourself to us and also explain who you are to the sister that has just spoken and who are the other people that are standing here?
Good morning, church. I am Mrs. Rebecca Emmy Reynolds, popularly known as Mama Becky. I am from Ghana. I am an evangelist in the Medina market. That was where I saw Mary. She came to me one day and told me all the stories she has told us. And I told her that it's only Prophet TB Joshua who can deliver her. So she should keep praying for me. If I get money, I will sponsor her to Lagos. And that was exactly what I did 2 weeks ago. And I was very happy when I saw Mary being delivered.
Well, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So this is the sister that actually met our sister in Ghana and actually sponsored her journey here to the Synagogue Church of All Nations 2 weeks ago after listening to what she passed through, stating that she needed to seek the face of God here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations for deliverance. So after her deliverance, sister, what happened? What happened next?
After the deliverance on Tuesday, Mary called me and said, the prophet has sent somebody to come and tell me that I should go and locate her mother in Volta region, Sogakope area. That was my first time of boarding a boat. But I sat on the boat and I went looking for her mother, Mama Happy. Fortunately, when I went, she was there. And there were some people who wanted to say no. But finally, the uncle in the house said, we should take her away. That was how I brought Mama to Accra. And she lived with me on Wednesday, Thursday, and then Friday, we set off to this place.
Okay, so you mean to say that the lady standing here is the mother of Mary?
Yes, that's Mama Happy, Mary's mother. Mama, that's Mary. That's Ebrese.
So, and the brother beside her, who is he?
The brother is Kofi. That's Mary's brother.
Well, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So, madam, you don't know this family before then. It was only through the deliverance of our sister that you were sent on this assignment to locate her mother that she had not seen. Is that right?
Yes. Wednesday was the first time I saw Mama Happy. That's Mary's mother and Kofi.
Okay. So, at this point, we want to hear just a quick word from our mother here, and we believe she will be speaking a local dialect, so our sister will help to translate. So, madam, you are very welcome in Jesus' name. Can you introduce yourself to us?
Udin the same. Udin, nebebia ufi.
Happy. Kodiva.
Or the mama happy. What Kodiva for bare 18 years, bare 2 months ago when we were back Ghana.
Okay, so we want to ask our mother, what can she say about what she has just heard now, and what does she have to say to our sister that is here?
Mama, then na betunya ka wo Mary asama wo kan ho. Mary, wo ba Mary. Then na wunim wo na ho.
Ah, mi ba mi hwe ni, se mi benya no wo hifa. Mi betuni ni anu. Mammy, so a young bassel made the hippie me banner. And the media and the young couple come, you should find us an enemy.
Mary is her daughter. She has been looking for her. She did never knew she would ever see Mary.
So, Mama, you mean to say that the sister here, you have not seen her for how many years?
Mama, I'm fear saying, and I won't want Mary.
If you say that this time, Yakitua, a female son, a female son.
When Mary was 3 years old, she saw her. Since then, she has never seen Mary.
Oh. So she's seeing her for the first time here in the Synagogue Church for Nations after deliverance. So, Mama, we know that most of what you need to say will not be said in public, but what do you want to say to Mary right now? As she's standing here, what do you have to say to her upon listening to her confession and seeing what she has passed through? What do you actually want to tell her?
Mama, me pa cha se se wo hu se Mary, Yakopon adom ho ho fini nyina afri ne mokọ den na wo woka efa Mary ho se se ya wo gina we. Nsamo bebre ni waka den na woka wo ho.
Ah, emi ajike,
weni aje papa. I'm very happy that I've seen Mary. So God should forgive her, for she didn't do that intentionally. She didn't know anything. It was the tradition that did that. Okay. So we beg God, God should forgive her.
Okay. So we have heard it from our mother here. She's actually asking God for forgiveness. She said it was the tradition of her time that actually caused her to take that decision to actually give her little daughter to this shrine And actually today, for the very first time, she is seeing her daughter here in the Synagogue Church of All Nations after her deliverance 2 weeks ago. So once again, brethren, we know that this is a very emotional moment. It's difficult for the family here to comprehend exactly what has happened. And we understand that it's not everything that can be said and done publicly, but we're bringing this to your attention for you to know what Jesus Christ has done. So we can see our mother right now is actually begging her daughter for forgiveness after what has happened.
Mary, you are not a Christian. Forgive Mama. Okay.
As Prophet TV Joshua says in his words, whether victims or perpetrator, we all stand in helpless need for the Savior's forgiveness. I have forgiven her.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God Almighty. That is the power of forgiveness. As our sister rightly said, that whether victim or perpetrator, we all stand in helpless need of God's divine forgiveness. Our mother here, upon hearing her confession, has realized her wrong. She said she's asking God for forgiveness because it was traditional at that time for her to take such an action, and she has seen the terrible repercussions in her daughter's life ever since. And we know that this is a reconciliation only God can bring about. It's not possible ordinarily if not for the intervention of God, who used his servant Prophet TB Joshua to actually locate Mary's mother far away in Ghana and bring her here today to reconcile with her daughter she's seeing for the very first time in so many years. One more time, people of God, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Okay, so finally, we are also seeing a young man here. We just want to hear a quick word from him. Brother, you are welcome.
Oh, je remercie le Dieu parce que aujourd'hui est un grand jour pour moi dans ma vie que j'ai retenu ma maman. Aujourd'hui, nous sommes arrêtés dans le corps des prophètes de Dieu. Il nous a glorifié. Je remercie le Dieu pour tout ce qu'il a fait pour nous. Que Dieu, il est toujours le même. Il est toujours mon sauveur. Il est toujours ton sauveur. Donc, je la rappellerai en prophète de Dieu. Amen.
Okay, I thank God for everything. I thank God because he's the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. I thank God because he used the Prophet TB Joshua to bring us here today. So I give all the glory to God.
Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ one more time. So we thank God for our sister's deliverance and what we have just seen now, this reconciliation. We pray that God will give you the grace to maintain this deliverance by making the word of God the standard for your life. And we know that upon hearing your confession, people of God are ready to come together to support you, to start a new life in Christ. Now you have been finally liberated from the shackles of Satan. And indeed, as Christians, the best is yet to come in Jesus' name.
Vous avez écouté le magnifique témoignage de cette famille et de cette femme qui est venue en particulier témoigner. Vous avez entendu, vous avez vu sa délivrance alors qu'elle était possédée de plusieurs esprits mauvais. Elle a expliqué comment, petite, elle a eu une enfance très difficile. Elle a grandi dans un lieu totalement occulte où elle devait marcher. Elle devait rester complètement nue toute la journée. Elle a expliqué comment elle a été violée, abusée par les anciens, comment elle a été dédiée à fabriquer des gris-gris et toutes sortes d'objets occultes. Vous avez pu voir l'idée, là vous voyez sur la photo, vous pouvez avoir l'idée de cette fille à son très jeune âge, comment elle a été secourue par une OGN qui ont négocié la libération d'elle et plusieurs autres filles qui étaient prisonnières de ce camp. Elle a expliqué comment elle a été plus tard rejetée par sa famille, mais qu'elle a été prise en compassion et emmenée à l'école, mais que malheureusement les esprits mauvais continuaient à la persécuter. Ensuite, elle a dit qu'il y a une femme, la femme ici présente que vous avez vue, qui s'est introduit en disant que c'est elle qui a emmené, qui a conseillé cette femme à venir à la synagogue Église de toutes les nations, comment à prise de compassion, a entendu son histoire, elle a sponsorisé son voyage et l'a emmené ici. Elle a comment expliqué ensuite sa délivrance, au moment où les évangélistes ont appliqué l'eau du matin, comment elle a reçu comme un coup de poing, elle a dit tous les démons qui étaient en elle ont commencé à fondre et aujourd'hui elle est libre au nom de Jésus-Christ. Elle recommande à tous de rester loin du péché, elle conseille à tous de venir à Dieu. La mère a également pris la parole, la mère de cette femme, la mère qui n'a plus vu sa fille depuis qu'elle a 3 ans. Elle a demandé à sa fille de la pardonner. La fille a répondu que tous ont besoin de pardon et à cause de cela, elle pardonne à sa mère. Témoignage continue.
Escuchamos este poderoso testimonio de esta joven que vino aquí a la sinagoga. Es el testimonio de liberación de 2 millones de espíritus malignos, entre ellos espíritu de diosa marina y espíritu de pitón. Ella nos cuenta que cuando era solamente una niña, los líderes del pueblo hablaron con sus padres que debían entregar a su hija a los espíritus para pagar un pecado, un gran pecado que cometió su tatarabuelo, por lo que sus padres accedieron a iniciar ese ritual llevándola al río. Allí la iniciaron y esa iniciación consistía en humillarla públicamente, rompiendo sus ropas y también, también constantemente sufría de abuso. Ella debía acostarse también con los hombres de esa tribu. Ella, sin desearlo, fue introducida desde muy pequeña al mundo espiritual marino. La gente de esa tribu la catalogaba como la niña maldita. Ella nos cuenta que era imposible escapar de esa tribu, ya que si la atrapaban sería brutalmente castigada. Pero un día logró escapar con tan solamente 8 años de edad, desnuda, sin alimento ni agua. Se encontró con unos extranjeros a los que les comentó cómo ella vivía y todo lo que le estaba sucediendo en esa tribu. 6 meses después, esos mismos extranjeros vinieron al lugar con una organización de protección a la niñez y pidieron al jefe de la tribu que libera a todas las niñas que ellos mantenían cautivos a cambio de dinero y otras cosas. El jefe de la tribu accedió, pero tiempo después de ser liberada, una mujer logró contactarse con sus padres, con su familia, pero cuando llegó a su hogar, sus padres no la aceptaron por el hecho de que era una niña maldita. Ella nos cuenta que durante toda su vida padeció de mucho sufrimiento y dolor. Tuvo la oportunidad de venir aquí a la SCOAN y ser ministrada por el agua de la mañana en el nombre de Jesús, y al momento esos espíritus fueron expuestos y expulsados en el nombre de Jesús a través del agua de la mañana. Hoy lo vemos aquí testificando que está totalmente libre para la gloria de Dios. No solamente eso, sino que el profeta Tibi Joshua se solidarizó con la historia de esta joven e intervino para que esta joven pueda volver a ver a su familia. Para la gloria de Dios, hoy su madre está aquí con su hermano pidiendo perdón por todo lo sucedido. Podemos ver el mover del Espíritu Santo trayendo liberación y reconciliación en esta familia en el nombre de Jesús. Seguimos con más testimonios.
After her glorious testimony, reunion and reconciliation with her family, Mary sat down to have a meal with her mother and brother for the first time in so many years. Let's join them at this happy occasion.
Actually, we thank God Almighty for this great day in my life. And I also thank the man of God, Prophet TV Joshua, and the Emmanuel TV, and the whole congregation for this great deliverance in my life. It's actually a new day and a new beginning in Christ Jesus. I also thank Mama Becky, my good Samaritan, for such a role that she played in my life. There's a word saying that in the road to your divine destiny, you need to meet the right people. So I think she is the right people. This is the first time in my life meeting with my family, and enjoying eating together as a table and enjoy it, and I'm so happy and overjoyed. I've actually forgiven her and forgiven everyone in my family in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.